Morning. Today, I'm going to take us through another beginner strength class. So we're going to call it beginner strength 2. But my goal is to incorporate some of the same things that we did last time, just because they're that important, but also bring in some new things, try to work some different muscles, use the hand weights a little bit more than our resistance band. So before we start, the things that you will need is a chair. So get a nice sturdy kitchen chair, something that will not move around on you, okay? Second thing you'll need, if you have it, are hand weights. So I have 5s, but anything you have, even if it's just a 1. And if you don't have hand weights, it's not a big deal. You're gonna do the arm movements without any weight. You'll still get the benefit, okay? So there's our first piece of equipment. And then our resistance band. So I have 2 different ones, so I'm gonna give you choices. There's those ones with the handles that you can buy at the store or whatever. So if you have that handy, grab that. We'll either use our handled one, or if you don't have that and you've had any sort of therapy, rehab, and you have a flat one that looks like this, grab it, because it will work just the same as the one with the handles, okay? So that's all we need as far as our equipment goes. So I'm going to start us in our chair, okay? Only because it's a great place for us to warm up some muscles seated before we take everything up. So what you're going to do is sit towards your front edge of your chair. So you want to be nice and tall. We're going to start with some deep breaths. Once you inhale, bring those arms up. Exhale down. So we're kind of going to do a little bit of flexibility, range of motion stuff here before we get into any strength. Good. All right, so we want to use our breathing. So inhale up, exhale down. Now remember, if your shoulders don't like to go all the way up right here, so you can stop anywhere you want. So you're going to go your range of motion, your comfort level. Good. 2 more. Last one, we're gonna keep those hands up there. I want you to hold them together so they're just above your forehead. We're gonna relax our arms and our shoulders, and we're gonna just gently rock from side to side right here, just nice, slow, and easy. We wanna just warm up those obliques, which are our outside core muscles. They keep us nice and stable. I see the sun peeking out. That's a good sign. It's Friday morning. I'm keeping track of what day and how long I've been videoing by the number of plank challenges. Good, last one. And down, good, relax those arms, shoulder rolls. I'm on plank challenge day number 10, so hope you guys are all hanging in there, 10 days plus, because we started doing some stuff before then. So I'm thinking we're almost at 2 weeks of being at home most of the time. Good, relax those shoulders. Next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna bring our arms chest level. You're gonna lose part of my arm in the wide screen, but that's okay. I want you to open and close. So a little bend in the elbows, stretch it wide, crisscross those arms in the front here. Good. Here's 3, 2, and 1. We're gonna keep those hands in the front. Turn your palms so they're pressing forward. We're gonna extend our arms out in front of the chest. Drop that chin down a little bit towards your chest while you're holding. Good. Remember, try to keep those deep breaths there. We want to bring that oxygen in as we're working and warming up. Good. Now we're going to lift our chin. Exhale, open out wide. So we're just extending those arms out wide, holding. Good. Relax right there. Bring those arms down. Next thing we're going to do is just a seated twist where we're going to move. So we're going to use our hand on the outside of our leg and on the back of that chair. So we stay nice and tall, and we just slowly turn, let our whole body turn. We're not just turning our head. We're not just moving our arms. We want to twist in the middle right here. We don't have to go quick on this. Just take your time. Good. 4 more times right here. 4, 3. Here's 2. Now, whatever side you're on, I wasn't saying right or left, so it doesn't matter. Whatever side you're on, I want you to hold that stretch. So hand on the outside of the knee. You can even hold on to the back of that chair now. It's called a seated twist. It's where we just turn, slowly twist, and stretch everything out here. Good. Switch sides right there. In the middle, nice, moving on. We're gonna warm up our hips. We're almost done, and then we're gonna stand it up. So I want you to do lateral step outs. That's where we step out to the side and then back in. Now, if you've ever been in my sober sneaker class and I have to use the slippery chair, here we are. This chair is gonna make me slide a little bit. So if you have a chair that has that really smooth surface and you feel like you're moving, just take your time. We're not gonna do very many of these, but seated is the best way for us to get those hips warmed up. Good, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, bring it up. I want you to do your V-sit. So we do that by bringing those legs wider, angle those toes up. Our chest is gonna come forward in front of our hips and our elbows are gonna stay on top of our legs. That's gonna make sure we don't overextend or overstretch. And then we slowly gonna bring that chest into the center there. We're gonna feel a nice, easy stretch for our hips. Good, make sure your breathing back is flat and neutral. You should be relaxed in the neck as well. And take your time, come on up, walk it in. Got one more thing we're gonna do, a couple on each side here, this last part. You're gonna go lift your leg up, extend, come in and down. Good, up, extend. So warms up our knee, get that quad and hip flexor working. Good, lift, extend, and down. Doesn't have to be a real high lift, we just wanna get it up off the floor enough so we can extend, come in. Two more, up, extend, in, and down. Good, last one. Nice, and switch legs, good. Up, out, in, and down. Good, so it's that double movement. We're doing an extension and that lift. Out, in, good. Keep it going, oops. My leg stopped moving. I figured it's early. I have to video everything early because otherwise kids and dogs, and that's never good. 2, 1 more. Nice, good, good. All right, let's stay here. Extend your right leg. Okay, so we're gonna extend our right leg. Do 4 deep breaths. So we're gonna do deep breaths to stretch and extend up, and then we're gonna hinge forward. So right here, I'll take you slow. Inhale up, good. Exhale forward. You're just hinging forward from the hips, reaching up, and then inhale back up. Good, exhale forward. 2 more times. Good, exhale. This is for the back of the leg as well as those arms, and this one we're gonna hold. So I need to bring your chest forward. Hand can just go on the top of the leg. We're bringing chest forward so we feel a stretch in the back of our leg right here. Good, bring it up and switch. Extend right here. Good, deep breaths up and down. Good, up right here. Exhale forward. Good, and down. Last one right here. Up and down. Good, hold it. And this song right here, we gotta hurry up because I love it. It's a good one to do warming up standing. So grab a quick drink if you need it. We're gonna get up and we're gonna move that chair to the side. I'm just gonna put mine off to the side where I won't get in my way. So take your time, make sure it's out of the way. You wanna have some floor space. Okay, if you still need your chair, you're gonna bring it in front of you for this part, because anytime you need to hold on, you're gonna hold on. I'm gonna move it because otherwise you will not be able to see anything that my legs are doing. So, right here. So remember, you can hold on. You can even have it on the side if you need to. I want you to have it handy in case you need to hold on. We're just marching. Good, we're just gonna move. 4, 3, 2. Take your march out wide, step it out wide. Keep marching. Nice, arms can move if you're not holding on. Back in the middle. Nice, back out wide. Here we go, we're switching our feet. Keep it wide, we're gonna tap. Okay, so legs are wide, tap it up, right? You can hold if you need to. If you're comfortable keeping those arms moving and not holding on, you're gonna do a reach across. Good, now if you can, you're gonna reach up and across. So if that bothers your shoulders, keep it chest level, okay? So up and across, optional. Good. back chest level right here. One more time. Good, two more. And one. Good, hold right here. Next thing, hold that chair if you need to. Step touch. Got a little dance routine, yeah? Step touch, good. If you're adding those arms up at chest level, again, this time, reach and pull. Nice. Good, good. Nice, keep those arms moving if you can. Reach from the top, pull down. Same thing when you're reaching up. If it bothers your shoulders, keep it chest level. Oh yeah, good. Back in front, right here, one more time. Almost. Two. And one. Good. March it. Here's that chair if you need it. We're going to switch it. Here we go. It's a heel tap right here. So tap that heel in the front. Right? If you're comfortable letting go, you're going to curl. Arms can curl. If you need to hold on, hold on. Good. Almost there. Bring those feet wide. Relax for a second. Deep breath. Good. Do that two more times. Inhale, sweep it up. And go one more. And one. Nice. All right. We are going to grab our hand weights, okay? So if you feel comfortable standing, you're going to stay standing for this. If you need to be seated, bring your chair back around where you can see me clearly so that you're not turning your head funny or anything. I'm gonna grab a quick drink of water here. All right, so we're gonna start with some arm ones. I'm gonna move a little closer so you can see me better. Good. All right, first thing we're gonna do, palms facing towards me, bicep curl. All the way up, all the way down. We're just gonna move from one exercise to the next, so we'll work similar muscles, just keep changing what we do. Four more, here's three, two, and one. Halfway here, press forward, pull back, press, pull, looks like this, out, pull, out, good, three, two, and one, good, hold here, up, halfway down, so a little quicker. Like a little pulse right there. We're getting biceps first. Up and down. Four, three, two, and one. Good, stay here. This is one I know we did it last time. It's so important we do it again. Internal rotation. So elbows stay right by your side. We're rotating those weights in towards the center and then back out for that rotator cuff right here. Working shoulders. Three, two, and one. Good, relax for a second. Next thing we're gonna do a couple for our shoulders, okay? So we're gonna start with a front raise. When we do that, we're just gonna alternate. So we're gonna do one at a time. Lift and lower right there, just to shoulder height, back down. Little bend in the elbow, good. If that bothers your shoulders to do a front raise, I want you to row and down, good. So upright row, a little less of that intensity in the front of the shoulder. So up to you, see how you're feeling. Always, always listen to your body. Up, good. Four, three, two, and one. Good, relax, let's roll those shoulders. We don't wanna put tension there, we just wanna make them stronger too. Good, and last one. Good, relax right there. Next we're gonna do, we're gonna bend our elbows, but we're gonna do a lateral raise. So we're gonna do one at a time again. So this is all shoulder. Good, lift, lower, right. Just to shoulder height, back down, up, down, good. Nice work, keep that going. Four, three, two, And one here, one more for shoulder round. We're gonna put those weights together in the center. External rotation, so back to rotator cuff. Elbows stay by our side. Out, back into the center, good. So we're only rotating as far out as you're comfortable. Depends on the shoulder. Good, three more. Nice, two, and one, good, relax again. Stretch that neck a second here, arms are just extended. And let's stretch the other way. This is a fun song, I'm gonna back it up. Now, this one is gonna be optional to move arms and legs together. I'm gonna show you what it looks like. You're gonna decide. If you don't wanna move your feet, I want you just working your arms, okay? Or if you really feel like your arms are tired and you wanna give them a break, then you'll put your weights down and do just the legs. So we're going back to that tap that we did in our warm-up, and we do those punches and those presses. We're gonna change them slightly. We're gonna go into this boxing round. We're gonna uppercut first, up and across. So you're punching that up towards the opposite shoulder. Almost, and one, good. Hold in the middle, so right in front of your belly button. Good, now if you were doing just the arms and you wanna do your legs, right here's your time, just the legs. Good. And here we go, punch it across. Good, good, right in front of that belly button, punch it out there. Good. You can sing along. You might not even be able to hear it. I kept the music softer on purpose so that you can make sure you're hearing my cues. Good. Relax those arms. Hold right here. Nice. Keep tapping. Uppercut, right here, go one more time. Nice work, come on, get them twice. Keep that belly button in, you want your core holding. You'll feel it working when we go across our body. Good, last one, hold right here. Just tap. Good, good, almost. Good, punch it right here. Last set. Keep it going, punch it across, come on. I feel like singing, but it's not loud enough. I'll spare you. Go relax those arms right here. Almost, we're gonna keep those taps. Nice. Almost, I think. Nice, and stop those feet. Right here, he's at the end. We're gonna bring our chest forward just a little. If you weren't holding the weights, it's okay. You can still do this with or without the weights. So keep those feet wide or chest forward. Just let your arms hang, stretch them out. You did good. I do love some boxing. It's good for us. A little bit of cardio, right? Heart rate should have gone up. I want you to set those down for a second and grab a quick drink here. So get water. I'm gonna make sure I'm telling you to drink water. Okay, we're gonna give our arms a break. You got that chair. Remember, if you want your chair in front of you so you can hold with both hands, you're going to have that option, okay? Can't remember what all we did the other day. We're doing calf raises, but these are so important that the fact that we're doing them again is because it's ingrained in my brain that we must do these often. All right, so we're lifting and lowering our heels up. I'll stay sideways. Good. You can hold. I'm more focused and concerned about you getting that nice lift, so hold on if you need to. Good. Three, two, and one. We're going to lift and hold right there. Bring it up. Good. Four. four, three, two, and one. Good. We're going to change our foot position. I believe we did tightrope the other day. So we're going to do our plie stance. We're going to pretend we're in a ballet studio. Heels are going to come in tight, and the toes are going to angle out, okay? We're still going to lift and lower. We're just doing it at that different angle, okay? So one more set of those calf raises right here. Hold if you need to. I backed up so you could see my feet. I can see them in my camera, so I'm hoping you can see what I'm doing. Two more. Good, good. We're going to lift and hold. One more time. Balance here. Four, three, two, and one. Good. Relax. We'll stretch those good here in a second. Next thing we're going to do, okay, this one, if you need to hold on, I want you to. We're going to work on that outside leg, okay? So we're going to go up, extend, in and down. So if you guys hit your left leg, you're going to go lift, extend, come in and down, just like we did in the chair. Now when we're standing, we work on our balance as well. So we're getting quad, hip flexor, just body weight exercises. This motion right here is so good for our hips and our big muscle here, that quad working. Four more. Good. Here's three, two, one more time. Good, good. I'm going to challenge you. We're going to do two balance holds. First one, knee comes up. Don't worry about your arm today. Hold it. Four, three, two. Bring it down for a second. Straighten it. We're going to do one more balance hold on this one. Straight leg. A little harder. You got it. Four, two, and one. Good. Relax. Nice job. My camera's fading in and out because the sun's trying to come out, and then it goes, must go behind the clouds. So if you see like light and dark, don't be worried. It's just my camera, it's having a hard time today. It just wants it to be sunny like me, but you know, maybe we'll get our wish later. All right, you guys are on your right leg. Now remember, hold that chair if you need it. Extend in and down. Good, up, out. Good. That lift doesn't have to be real high. You go as high as you're comfortable. We're trying to bring it up towards hip level. Extend it up. In and back down. Good. Ooh, see, working on balance. Three, two, one more. Good, good. We're going to lift and hold. Good. Bring it down. Straighten that leg. One more lift and hold. Up right here. Four, three, two, and one. Good. Turn back to that chair. If you're facing forward, that's fine. I'm only sideways so you guys can see me. We're going to stretch those couple of things. So you're going to step back, and I want you to get that heel pushing into the ground. Doesn't matter which leg on this one. So step one leg back. The leg that's in the back is going to be straight, and you're going to keep that heel down on the floor. Hopefully you can see my feet. There we go. I see them. I see them. There they are. Good. So we want to just let that hips push forward a little bit. We'll make that stretch deeper, but we're working on that calf stretch since we worked those pretty good here. Good. Three, two, and one. Good. Stay here. Relax and lift. I want you to bring that heel up. What we're going to do is bend our knee. So the back leg, you're going to bend the knee and try to drop it towards the floor. Just a little drop. Now it's going to stretch it flexor. Okay? So stay nice and tall. I want you to see if you can feel that right here. Just like gently pushing down. Doesn't have to be real big. Good. In and relax. Stretching the other side. Step it back. Good. That heel on the floor. Leg extended. Shift those hips forward. Where you're going to feel that stretch. Good. Three, two, and one. Good. Lift up on the toe. Relax those legs. Little drop. So right front knee bent a little bit more. You see that? Back knee, you bend it and let it just sit in towards the floor. You're going to just feel a nice, easy stretch in the front of the hip and quad. Just a nice, easy one. Bring it up and in. Good. All right, grab water. And then I want you to get your resistance band. Remember, Either or, you decide. Or you can do just arm movement without either, okay? Anything of the above. We can make any of this work from home. Good. All right, so we got our straight band here. Resistance, right? We create resistance by bringing our hands closer, right? We make it easier by bringing them out wider on the band. Okay, so we want to start with them about shoulder width, and then you adjust as necessary. The handles will swing a little bit, but we're not going to go real fast. So we did this one the other day when we were working the band first, but this is a really good one for our chest, front of the shoulders, a little bit of biceps. So we want to pull and extend, so it comes all the way wide, right? Take your time, out and back in. Now, if you're not doing that, you're just gonna open and close your arms like we did in warm-up, okay? So if you don't have the band or something doesn't feel right in your shoulder when you do these, I don't want you using the band, okay? Not necessary to use it. You can do it just with movement, range of motion. Four more. Good. Three. Two. One more. Good, relax, bring it in half, okay? So if you have the orange band, like my flat one, you can fold it in half if it was really long, or you can just hold it. Okay, we're gonna go out in the front. Okay, right here, moving with that rotation here, side to side. Good, so I can even turn sideways. You don't lose my arms as much. See how I'm rotating in that middle section? Get a twist with it. Four, three, two, and one. Good. I'm going to turn back to the front. You guys stay right where you are. We're going to lift and lower. Remember, watch the shoulders. Don't go any higher than you're comfortable. We're going all the way up and down. Good. Just shoulder movement. Good. Two more. This one we're holding. We're going to do one more. This is that one we did the other day as well. Arms are up. And we're going side to side. If you're not holding the band, then you can just hold your hands together overhead like we did in warm-up. Rock side to side. Good. Four. Three. Two. And one. Nice. Bring it down. Let me see how we're doing. All right, good. We're at about 27 minutes, almost 28. I want to use this band for our legs, but we're gonna do that in our chair. So I'm gonna slide my chair around, okay? We'll be able to do a little bit of arms as well when we're seated, okay? Oh, actually, I have to back up so you can see my feet. I'll get this, don't you worry. I'll figure it out. All right, so you still might be able to see my feet. Maybe I'll do a camera movement. See, this is how professional I am. Give me 1 second. Oh, much better. Look, up close and personal, and you can still see my head. Nice. Look at this. We're going even closer. I'm loving it. Okay, so you all, any of you who know me, I think everybody who's watching this knows me somehow. We're putting that under our feet, right? You can do it with your flat band, too. You just have to be able to hold on to that end of this flat band, okay? Once you have it securely under your feet, you want it like in the middle of your shoe, then you're gonna bring those handles in between your knees, and you're actually gonna make an X. You're gonna crisscross and switch hands, okay? So once you do that, you can walk those feet all the way in. We create resistance by pulling those handles up by our hips. So my hardest position would be all the way up. If I need to make it easier, I slide it down. Now my band is super duper long. So when I grab the handles, I feel nothing. So I'm actually just gonna grab my tube because I can, but you're gonna just hold on to the handles. Now, the motion, I can't even talk anymore. It's like a tongue twister. All right, so the motion we're doing was what we did in warm-up. So you don't even need the band if you don't have one, okay? So here's where we're doing. We're holding that band if you're using it. And we're gonna go step out, back to center, other side. Good. Remember those lateral step outs we did at the beginning? Out, center, other side. So before you step out, make sure that other foot's holding the band on the floor. Good. Out, center, other side. Four more. Three, two, Good. Relax for a second. We're going to bring those handles down. We're going to walk our feet back out about hip width. Keep your crisscross. I still had to adjust. I'm not going to hold the handles. We're doing an upright row. So you're going to extend your arms now. They're going to be right in between your knees. We're going to row and bring it back down. So pull, extend. Nice. So upright row. We're going up towards that shoulder. Extending back down. Here's four, three, two, and one. Good. We threw that in, gave our hips a little break. Going back to step outs, okay? Second step, we're going to keep it simple. We're doing the same thing. Out, center, other side. Good. Sometimes simple is better. Good. Right there, you're getting as wide as you're comfortable. Working against that resistance. Good, good. Four more. Three, two, and one. Good. Back in the middle row. Open those feet out again. Extend those arms. We're going to do second set of row. We are going to slightly change this. I want you to see if you can pull both arms up at the same time. So row, extend back down. Take your time. Up, down. Nice work. Four more. Three, two, and one. Nice job. We're done with those. Bring it up and relax. Nice work. We can put that band aside. All we have left is flexibility, kind of like a chair yoga-ish, but we're going to just stretch things out. We'll do a lot of the similar stretches we did in our beginner strength class one, but I might throw a couple extra ones in since I have time. But all the time in the world. Keep you on the same side as me. So you're gonna extend your left leg, okay? So left leg is straight, right leg is just holding here. Remember, if you're on a slippery chair, just be careful. I don't want you sliding off, okay? Even though I can't be in the same room with you, I always tell them, not on my watch, all right? We wanna be super careful. Anything we're doing, just take your time. All right, leg extended, toes pointed up. All we're gonna do is stretch now. When we work on flexibility, we take our time. Slowly bring that chest forward. Hand is on the top of the leg. Okay, we're just holding, right? So as I bring my chest forward, that's where I'm gonna feel that stretch. We try to keep our leg as straight as we can when we're stretching. And if you're the kind of person that likes to do something like this on the floor, you could do some of these on the floor, but we will be doing some cross things, and I just didn't want to open that can of worms. So I know sitting in a chair actually is a really great place to stretch. Lift up here. Good. Let's pull that in towards our chest, either underneath that leg or in the front. Good. And I mean, if you have certain stretches that you've been doing, I want you to just do whatever is helping you get through all this. Good. That point and flex right there. We're just letting that lower leg stretch. So go slow. Good. One more. Bring that down. We're going into our leg cross position. So you're going to go at the ankle if you need to. This is where we go if we need to watch our knees and our hips. So lower position, not as deep of a stretch. Once I put that leg up on top and cross up high, I've now made it a deeper stretch. So I really have to pay attention to my knees and my hips. So once you're crossed, either at the ankle or on top, you're going to slowly bring your chest forward. Nice, easy stretch there. So our back is flat and neutral, right? I'm not rolling my back. I'm not tensing my shoulders. My head and neck are just neutral. I just want you to feel that nice stretch here on the left side in that hip. Good. Take your time. Lift up, uncross, and switch. Good. So this one we're going extended on your right leg now. Going back through. We're going to do the same thing on this side, okay? Chest forward. Slowly come into that stretch. Keep that leg as straight as you can. Toes pointed to the ceiling. I wish I had a good story to tell you, but I don't. I might think of one. Good, good. Nice and slow. Lift up out of that. And we're going underneath or the front of that leg. Either one right there. That slow point and flex. Almost done. We're just going to loosen everything up, stretch it out, try to release some tension. I know it's hard being cooped up in the house for as many days in a row, but we're just going to try to keep moving. I hope you are enjoying these videos, and I hope you're doing them. So now you'll have two choices, and I promise I'll work on another one. Okay, crossing down on that ankle. Remember, this is where we have to cross low, especially for knees and hips. Once we go in that high position, going to be a deeper stretch for those muscles. So knees and hips, want to be real careful. So our chest coming slowly forward again. One more time. Got to make sure you're breathing, right? This is my cue. I like to do breathe through it, so don't hold your breath. And bring it up right here, uncross. My favorite stretch, always, if you come to my classes, you know it's my favorite. V-sit, right? Wider position with those legs. Toes are angled out, elbows on top. We're coming forward nice and slow with that flat back, right? Back is neutral. And relax that chest coming forward. You're gonna feel that stretch in the hips. So you decide how low you wanna go. Oh, that's like a limbo. How low can you go? I miss you guys. I'm sure most of my silver sneakers, because I've been sending it to you personally. I hope you're doing these videos. I do miss you. And for anybody else who doesn't come to my silver sneaker class, who just wanted a nice, easy, lightweight workout with stretching, thanks for joining me and taking the class. I really hope it's helping you guys get through. Good, walking feet in. We're gonna do our seated twist. I'm gonna throw a curveball at you. If you're comfortable, you're gonna turn. So we're gonna turn to the left first. Okay, so in our sideways position, we can actually grab the back of our chair and twist a little deeper than when we're facing forward. So you're gonna turn to face the back of the chair. Okay, you're gonna lose my face for a second. We're gonna hold that chair, gently pull against the chair. Feel your body twist and hold, right? So we're twisting and holding. I was watching, like I can see you. Oh, good, just hold. Take some deep breaths, then nice stretch through the middle. Relax, release that, and walk it around. Okay, we got my little slip and slide chair. Okay, so other side, same thing, knees together, nice and tall. Turn to the back of the chair. You're gonna hold it with both hands again. Slowly turn. Good. And relax, good. And come back to the center. And now we can relax right here in that upper body. Once you take a deep breath up, good, hold, just that little lift and reach towards the ceiling, lift your chin. Good, nice and slow, relax, lower those arms and relax chest level here. So we're gonna press straight forward. All right, I'll get them out of my face, but we're pressing forward and just letting that chin drop towards our chest there. Hold and get that stretch. You want to feel that in the upper back and shoulders. Good. Relax those arms. Bring that head back to center. We're doing our airplane stretch. We did this the other day on that beginner strength class number one. So you hold the back of the chair. So if your chair's not really super conducive to holding, I want you just to try to put those arms behind. You can even hold the bottom of the chair. But all we're going to do, arms are in a straighter position. If we slowly lean forward, we're gonna feel that stretch in the chest and shoulders. I tried to put those two muscle groups together. The chesters, the shoulders, yeah, shoulders and chest. I can tell that I've been talking a lot, so it's gonna be a tongue twister if I'm not careful. Good, last deep breath, and bring it up. Good, roll those shoulders to the back here one more time today. Everything relaxed. Good. Arms right by your side. Drop that ear over to the shoulder. Good. Other side. And then back in the middle. Good. And I really want to thank you again for coming and joining my class. With all this uncertainty and everything going on, I wanted to just let you guys know that the community center, a lot of you are silver sneakers, so it doesn't necessarily affect you money-wise because your membership is free, but the community center does incur a lot of expenses even when our members aren't in the building. So We do have a link on our website if you have the means to donate, because we will not have any money drafted from anybody's account that's a member of the community center on April 1st, so no money will be coming in. It's just one of those things that we certainly would appreciate any offer or any donation that you were able to give, but it's absolutely only if you're able to. We know this is a tough time for everybody, and we want to just continue to provide the best service and everything for our members. So having said that, have a wonderful day, and I will do a beginner strength 3 class next week, so stay tuned. I'm going to try to do one a week until we get back together. Feel free to try my yoga classes as well. If you can be on the floor, yoga 1 was all on the floor, okay? Yoga 2, we were standing we were standing the whole time, I think. And then yoga 3 was a combination, so that one would be the most difficult. But yoga 1, highly recommend it. It was super duper relaxing. And I miss all of my people at the community center, and I hope you're doing well and staying safe.